Hello, I'm Sylvie Rigaret. I'm working in ST in Imaging Division, where I am in charge of the marketing and technical support team in EMEA. Today, we'll present you our ST time of flight ranging sensors, also called FlightSense. Here is the agenda. After a short introduction, I will briefly explain the use cases and applications. Then we will go through the time of flight mass market roadmap and complete this presentation with some highlights on the new product's features. ST is a pioneer and a worldwide leader in time of flight solutions. We have already developed our fourth generation of all-in-one ToF solutions, and we deploy them since 5 years. Our products are already embedded on more than 170 phones with more than 15 smartphone OEMs, but we have also in parallel hundreds of non-wireless end products on which our FlightSense solutions are used. We have already deployed more than 42,000 evaluation kits and sold more than 1 billion of units. We are mastering the complete end-to-end supply chain from the time of flight pixel expertise up to the advanced packaging know-how and manufacturing. Let me explain you the time of flight principle. This is a method for measuring a distance between the sensor and an object that is based on the time difference between the emission of a VCSEL light signal and its return to the sensor after being reflected by the object. The photons are emitted by the laser, are reflected on the target, and trigger an avalanche when they are coming back to the SPAD array. SPAD standing for single photon avalanche diode. This means that the time between the emission of the photons and the avalanche is measured and translated into a target distance. This technology is a proprietary technology and is independent of the target size, color, and reflectance. It's very fast, as the distance can be computed in a few milliseconds, and low power, meaning that this principle is fully adapted to battery-operated systems. The illumination is based on a truly invisible 940 nanometer, meaning that the user will not be distracted by such illumination. ST time of flight sensors are all-in-one solutions, means that we embed on the same module the illumination and the sensor. So there is no need for external components, and thanks to this optimization, we can propose a perfect mix of size, performance, and cost. So the ToF sensor embeds the emitter, which is a VCSEL, vertical cavity surface emitting laser. It's a high power VCSEL following the full class 1 safety. We can integrate some advanced optics with some integrated infrared filter depending on the product reference. And on the receiver part, we have the SPAD array, single photon avalanche diodes. We have also the VCSEL driver and all the RAM and ROM necessary to run the algorithms. The complete module is developed for the front-end part in France, and all the final test and module assembly is done in ST line based in Shenzhen. Our FlightSense products benefit from the ST longevity program. It means that we commit a minimum of 7 years mass production from the product introduction date. As you can see, most of our products are part of this program since January 2019. Further information on this 7 years longevity program can be found on ST.com. FlightSense use cases and applications. Here are some examples of typical applications in which ST FlightSense products can be used. On the left, the camera assistant with a laser autofocus and touch to focus use case. Our products can be used also for ranging and proximity by computing a very accurate distance up to 4 meters. It can be used also for multispectral and light flicker measurement and correction. For face identification, our products can propose the perfect and optimized mix between cost, power, and size for instance, face anti-spoofing use case. Our products are used also for presence and user detection in front of tablets, laptops. This is important for security and comfort, but for also power saving and eye protection. And last one is the depth map and augmented reality and virtual reality, thanks to some advanced gesture recognition. The flight sense sensors allow different main functions. They can be used for ranging measurement, for proximity sensing, for multi-zone distance measurement, for multi-target distance measurement, for presence detection, and 3D sensing. They can enable multiple use cases, very large ones like sailing and cliff detection, but also content analysis and load management. They can be used also for any kind of control, like gesture control or volume control, but also occupancy detection, parking occupancy, people counting, and SLAM. Of course, they can be used to develop unlimited markets. There is an unlimited number of markets and applications for which our FlightSense products can be used. Here is just an example of them with laptops and tablets for presence detection, but also smart home, faucets, dispensers, white goods with a proximity detection. Our products can be used also for stock management, for logistic, warehouse, tanks, vending machines also. We have also a huge number of use cases on robots with service robots and cleaning robots. Again, this is just an example, and we count on our customers to enable a lot of new use cases. Let's focus now on the FlightSense mass market roadmap. This FlightSense roadmap highlights the 5 FlightSense sensors that are today in mass production and also the next generation that will be promoted early next year. All these products are represented with a series of pictograms that corresponds to the main function. These products are also represented depending on the maximum distance measurement in centimeter on the x-axis. Let's start on the left side of the roadmap with the VL6180V1. This proximity sensor is capable to measure distances up to 50 centimeters and is offering a very good linearity at close distances. The next one is the VL53L0CX. This ranging sensor can be used to measure distances up to 2 meters and is also offering very good performance under ambient light environment. The VL53L3CX is a new proximity and multi-target sensor that is introduced on the market this year. This sensor, indeed, thanks to the histogram function, is capable to measure the distance of several objects, and for each object, it returns the exact distance with the sensor. This FlightSense sensor has also a smudge correction capability and very good performance under ambient light environment. If you need to measure longer distances, you can use the VL53L1CB. This one is also a new FlightSense sensor that we have introduced on the market this year. This long distance and multi-target sensor can measure distances up to 3.2 meters. You have on this sensor the possibility to program the field of view with a maximum field of view at 27 degrees. And this sensor has also a sequential, is a multi-zone sensor with a sequential 2x2 zones, allowing so on each zone to detect several objects and to return the exact distance with these objects per zones. This sensor has also the smudge correction and very good performance under ambient lighting conditions. If you need to further increase the maximum distance measurement up to 4 meters, then you can use the VL53L1X, that is a long distance sensor. This sensor has also the capability to have a programmable field of view and has also very good performance under ambient light conditions. All these products are today in mass production, and you have a sixth product that is mentioned in this roadmap, that is the VL53L5CX. This multi-zone sensor will be promoted on the market early next year, and thanks to its 64 zones, you have the capability to use this sensor for mini depth map application, allowing maximum distance measurements up to 4 meters. This table gives further information on each FlightSense product, like the field of view, the power consumption, the size of the drivers, and the size of the module. As you can see, the VL6180V1 has a very low power consumption at 1.7 milliamps and has a very good, extremely good linearity at close distance from 2.5 centimeters. The L0CX and L3CX have exactly the same size of the modules and are pin-to-pin compatible. The L3CX has, in addition, a complete immunity against crosstalk above 80 cm, and below 80 cm, we have an automatic smudge compensation. The L1CX and L1CB have also exactly the same size of the module and are pin-to-pin compliant. You can configure the field of view. This is configurable by software. You have an optic, a lens on the receiver part for each of these two references. And you have also a total immunity against crosstalk above 80 cm for the L1CB and the smudge compensation below 80 cm. Highlights on the new product features. The VL53L1CX and VL53L1CB have the capability to program the field of view. It means that you can select a reduced number of spots for the region of interest sensing area to limit the viewing angle of the sensor device. This means that you will have to set a region of interest, meaning positioning the reduced sensing area at a selected place on the spot array to detect and measure the distance of any objects in this specific ROI field of view. As you can see, the setup of the ROI zone is fully configurable in software. The minimum size is 4x4 spots corresponding to a diagonal field of view of 15 degrees, up to 16x16 spots, meaning the total array corresponding to a maximum diagonal field of view of 27 degrees. You have a specific ROI application note associated to the VL51L1CX available on ST.com. The VL53L3CX and VL53L1CB have the histogram function. It means that they can perform multi-object detection and output the ranging distance for each detected object. Thanks to the technology, the direct time of flight principle, you can measure multiple objects within the sensing area. If you compare to indirect time of flight solutions, these cannot output multiple beams and extract the distance with a correct resolution. So this is a key advantage of the direct time of flight sensors. This function of multi-object detection can be useful if you need, for instance, to remove the background or to allow a first object detection. Let's go deeper on the histogram architecture of the L36 and L1CB flight sense sensors. The histogram is based on 24 beans. A bean is represented as a time window that corresponds to the amount of photons back on the sensor during a certain period of time. In order for an object to be detected, it has to cover roughly 3 beans, meaning that this is equivalent to roughly 80 centimeters. That's why we say that the typical depth separation between two objects has to be at least 80 centimeters to detect two different objects. On the left side of the histogram, we have represented the crosstalk and smudge that corresponds to a certain amount of noise. We use this information to set the threshold, that is the minimum signal for valid target detection. That's why we can say that the histogram allows cover glass crosstalk immunity beyond 80 cm and dynamic smudge compensation. Let's focus now on the crosstalk immunity principle. In the case a cover glass is used, a crosstalk calibration has to be performed to allow a very accurate distance measurement. We distinguish two use cases. Beyond 80 cm, there will be zero impact of the crosstalk from the cover glass on the target. So we have a complete immunity to crosstalk. Below 80 cm, we will have to perform a crosstalk calibration in order to compute the crosstalk level and remove this noise level to the raw range data in order to get a crosstalk-free range information. The VL53 L36 and VL53 L1CB have dynamic fingerprint smudge compensation function. This is important to consider in the case you have smudge or dust or fingerprint on the cover glass that will generate some noise, so some crosstalk. Again, depending on the distance that you need to measure, beyond 80 cm, the smudge will have no impact on the distance measurement thanks to the histogram function. But below 80 cm, you will have to perform a dynamic calibration, meaning to consider the crosstalk increase due to the smudge to calculate this new crosstalk calibration data for smudge compensation and then to remove it from the raw data. For each of our flight sense products, we have developed a complete ecosystem and several tools in order to allow the customers to evaluate the performance of our solutions. For instance, we propose some expansion boards that we called X-Nucleo for each of our flight sense products, and those boards are fully compliant to the STM32 open development environment. These boards can be ordered as a standalone board or as a package with the STM32 Nucleo. You can order also standalone breakout boards. These expansion boards can accept breakout boards, so through connectors or flying wires, but you can also separate these breakout boards in order to use only the mini PCB that is easier to integrate into a customer device. We also propose some examples of cover glasses that you can use for testing and after that for, let's say, mass production. And we also propose in our tools three different spacers in order to create various air gaps. All these systems can be ordered. And we have a complete, let's say, software tool that is also available for each of our flight sense products. Last but not least, I encourage you to regularly visit our ST website, www.st.com, online marketing, in order to get access to numerous online support tools and also to a set of use cases, webinars and videos. You will find some video examples like calibration-free dirty environment cover glass solutions based on the VL53L1X, but also some gated started videos with, for instance, the L1X sensor, and some videos demonstrating some use cases like people counting using a single ST time of flight sensor, the L06, and also a video highlighting a smart shelves use case with a programmable region of interest on the VL53L16. We have also put on ST YouTube channel several videos like the mini LiDAR that is based on 9 VL53L1CX and also a reflectometer example based on the VL53L0CX. This is the end of the presentation. Thank you for joining it. Now our ST Flight Sense experts are available through chat in order to get and answer all of your questions. Thank you.